I created and filmed this really simple, pretty purple eye look. If you guys want to see how I created and achieved this look, please keep on watching. So obviously I'm going to start with a fresh, clean face, and I'm going to put my braids back so that they're out of the way. I know that my skin is pretty marked up. It's kind of bad, but yeah. I'm going to start with the Maybelline Baby Skin Primer. I really like this. It kind of feels like Vaseline, but it gets the job done. I'm just going to put that all over my face. Next, I'm going to go in with the Airspun Loose Face Powder. I'm just going to put this where I get oily. I notice when I skip this step, my makeup tends to break up a little more, like especially around my mouth because I'm talking all day, and like on my nose. I have really oily skin, so this just helps control the oil and helps my makeup to last a little longer. Next step are brows. I'm gonna take a spoolie and just brush the hairs upward. It's gonna give me a better idea of what shape and make them easier to work with. Then I'm gonna take the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow Powder, not the pomade, and this is in the shade Ebony, the color Ebony. And I'm just gonna fill them in. This step is pretty self-explanatory. I'm just following the natural shape, the natural arch of my brow. I personally like the powder better than the pomade. I think it's easier to work with, and honestly, I just want to fill them in. I don't want to draw them on. So, yeah. Now I'm just doing my other eye, my other side, and my eyebrows were threaded like a week ago before this, so when my eyebrows are done and like neat, it makes it easier for me to fill them in and to shape them. I would recommend. Then I'm gonna do these like hair-like strokes upward in the front of the brow. It'll make it look more natural. Then I'm gonna take the Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer in the color Sand, and I'm just gonna use this to sculpt my brows underneath. I'm gonna put it on the back of my hand because the applicator is kind of hard to, you know, control. So put it on the back of my hand and use a flat brush that I got from the hair store. And just use that to shape underneath my brow, getting as close as possible, being as precise as possible so that they're nice and neat. This is honestly like the longest part for me, the eyebrows, the eyes. Then I'm just putting the concealer on the rest of the eyelid. This is going to serve as the base for our eyeshadow. Next, I'm going to take this concealer brush from Real Techniques, and I'm just going to blend out the concealer on my eyelid under my brow. As you can see, this concealer blends out beautifully. It has amazing coverage, and I just love the color. Then I'm going to take the NARS Natural Radiant Foundation in the shade Caddis. It's like medium deep 3. Putting it on the back of my hand again and taking another flat brush to shape the top of my brow. Same thing for my other brow. So I kind of go back and forth with the brow. Sometimes I mess up and get some foundation on my brow and I have to go back in and fill it in. So that's what I'm doing here. And I'm just gonna go back and forth to make sure it's to my liking. Next, I'm gonna go back with that Real Techniques concealer brush and just keep blending. Then I'm gonna take this flat brush. I got it from TJ Maxx. I'm not sure what the brand is, but I'm using that to blend out the top half of my eyebrows. Again, going back and forth with the concealer brush. My camera cut off right here, but basically I just took a powder brush from Real Techniques and going back with the Airspun powder and setting my eyes with the powder. Finally getting into eyes, I'm going to go in with the Jackie Ina palette, her collab with Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I'm going to take that purple shade called Big Wig. And I'm going to take my shadow blending brush and tap on the excess and put it in the crease of my eyes. If we hadn't set our concealer with the Airspun powder, then blending eyeshadows would be a pain. The concealer would keep moving around and the shadows would just be really, really difficult to blend. So that was an important step. I'm being sure to keep the purple in my crease and in my crease only. Next, I'm going to go in with the Makeup Revolution x Tammy palette. It's like her carnival collab. And I'm going to take this shade on the far right. The shade names are on the back of the palette, and I believe it's called Moss, M-A-S. It's just kind of like a lighter purple, like a magenta. And I think it's a perfect color to blend out this darker purple. So I'm just taking that and going right above where I put Big Wig. And I'm blending it upwards. I thought it was the perfect color to blend out the darker purple. I felt like the colors really blended into each other well. So whenever you're blending, you kind of want to go back and forth with the shadows because the shadows can get lost. So I'm going back in with the Jackie Ina palette and making sure that that dark purple doesn't get lost. Using the same palette, I'm going to use the shade Supreme. It's like a really bright true pink, and I'm going to use a fluffier brush and just put that pink on the outside, the very, very outside. So we kind of went from dark purple to like a magenta to like a true pink. As you can see, I'm only keeping it on the outside. So the same idea, you just want to keep blending all your colors. I only used three so far, so I'm going back in with Big Wig and the same color from the Tammy palette and just making sure that all my colors blend evenly and nicely. Next, I'm gonna take a single shadow from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's called Enchanted and it's kind of like a pressed pigment. And I'm going to put it on a flat brush, take my setting spray and just spray it. That's just how you get the color to come out a little bit more. And I'm going to put that on my lid. It's really dark, but it has a little bit of like shimmer in it. I don't know if you can't really tell from far away, but once it's all done, you'll see what I mean. But I'm keeping that on the lid. And so just to make that look a little neater, you want to go back with your other brushes and just blend around it so it doesn't look like a harsh line. So this is all just blending, going back and forth with all my colors. Going back into the Tammy Revolution palette, I'm gonna take the second color in the palette. I believe it's called Socra. I'm gonna only put that in the center. So the other color wasn't as like shimmery or bright as I thought it was gonna be. So I just took the shimmery purple from the Tammy palette and I'm putting it only in the center. This is gonna create like a halo effect. Only keeping the glitter in the middle creates this really pretty effect on the eyes. Then, of course, going back with my other brushes and blending around it to make sure all the colors are blended. Then I'm gonna go back into the Jackiana palette. This palette is so good. There's so many colors you can work with. But I'm gonna take the color Trust Issues and I'm gonna put that in the inner corner. Next, I'm gonna color correct. I'm going to take the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color orange and just use it as a corrector. I'm going to put that all on my dark spots, which is basically everywhere. And then this is like an interesting brush. I don't know. It came in a Sephora brush set and I'm just going to use that to blend out the orange corrector. Using the same foundation from earlier, I'm going to put this now on the back of my hand and I'm going to use my finger to just first apply it all over my face. Again, this is in the color Caddis. Then I'm going to take my Morphe mattifying spray and then I'm going to take a Real Techniques blending sponge and just blend that into the foundation. This is going to allow my makeup to last a little bit longer and prevent makeup transfer. I recommend doing this and then once again at the end of all your makeup. Rather than doing it once, I think spraying it on twice, you will get better results. This is just self-explanatory. I'm just still blending until it's all like blended into the neck and around my ear. Then going back into that first shade that we used, Big Wig, I'm gonna put that on the lower lash line. Then I'm gonna go into the shade Pinker. It's in between Big Wig and Supreme. And I'm going to use that to blend out the outside. This area is known as like the outer V. And I'm just using that to blend out all the purples and pinks because it's like the perfect shade in between. Taking my other brush, I'm just cleaning that up. This is how the eyes look so far. Next, I'm gonna take Tarte Shape Tape in the color Tan Deep Sand, and I'm gonna put that everywhere where I want to highlight. Then I'm gonna take the LA Girl Pro Concealer, and this is in the color Medium Beige. It's a little bit lighter than the Tarte Shape Tape, which is what I want. I want a little bit of a lighter highlight, and you'll see some people doing this. They'll put a lighter concealer on top of the other concealer. But it all serves the same purpose. Just want a brighter under eye and a really bright highlight. Now I just want my concealer to sit for a little bit, so I'm taking like a pamphlet or like a brochure just to fan it down and then taking that same Real Techniques brush and blending it out with that. This brush is really, really good for blending out concealer. I love it. Thank you. because the concealer kind of got on my eye, I'm gonna go back in with that shadow brush. I really like the formula of the Airspun powder, but it's kind of light and I notice I get flashback with it, so I'm gonna mix it with the Morphe setting powder, and it's in the color Banana Rich. So just mixing a yellow powder with like a white translucent powder, it gives me the perfect color that I want. So you'll see that just mixing the two together with the powder brush from Real Techniques, and I'm packing that into the skin, like pressing it. I don't like leave it there, I just like press it into the skin. And that color is like perfect for me. I don't get flashback, and it really just makes my makeup look like skin again. And I don't just put this under my eye, I also put it on my nose, on my chin, especially around my mouth and on my forehead. Then I'm going to take the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Espresso, and I'm going to use this for contour. A little goes a long, long way with this, like just put the bare minimum, because once you start blending and pressing it out, it like spreads out a lot. And I'm using a Real Techniques, this is actually a foundation brush, but I'm using it for contour. Going back with the powder brush, I'm just going to press the powder kind of like on the where the lines are a little too harsh. To make the contour a little bit bolder, I'm going to just put the powder like a line directly underneath it, and then take my foundation brush that I used a long time ago and just use that to blend it out. Because there's leftover foundation, it's going to like blend everything out seamlessly. Then I'm going to take the Fenty Beauty bronzer. This is in Coco Naughty, and I'm just going to go over where I contoured. Anytime that you use like a liquid product, you always want to set it with some sort of powder. Then I'm going to take the MAC Studio Fix powder. This is in NCW44. It's the shade above C8, and I'm just going to put that. Initially, I was putting it kind of around my mouth, but then I just put it everywhere because it all needed to be blended together. Then fixing up my eyes a little bit, and then taking the Morphe mattifying spray and spraying my face again. Then you want to press that into the skin with the sponge, using the end of the sponge because there's no product on the back of it. Then I'm going to highlight with the Fenty Beauty highlighter. This is in Hustler Baby. Love this highlighter. And I'm putting it on the Cupid's bow, my nose. A little bit on my brow, and then on my cheeks. Now into lips, we're going to use the NYX lip liner. This is also called Espresso, and I'm just going to line my lips like so. Then I'm going to take the Anastasia liquid lipstick. This is called Stripped. It's like the perfect nude. I love this color, especially with the brown lip liner. Thank you. Using a lip gloss that I got from the hair store, it's just called coconut oil something. I'm gonna put the clear gloss on top. It was like a dollar. I love this lip combo. It's so cute and simple. Now I'm gonna put mascara on my eyes. It's just a Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara. Get it from Walgreens or CVS. And I'm just gonna coat this on my bottom lashes and my top lashes before putting on falsies. These lashes are just from Sephora. They don't have a style name, but they are Anastasia Beverly Hills lashes. And I looked all over the box. There's no style for these. They were just there on the shelf. So those are the ones that I'm wearing. Then you want to go back into the mascara and just blend your lashes with the fake lashes. I have really curly lashes, so this is really hard for me. And that's the final look. I hope you guys liked it. I had a lot of fun, and I think it's really, really cute. Let me know what you guys think of it. Thanks again for watching. Bye.